Hi, my name is Ricardo Böhme and I'm working as an application engineer for our flow measurement products here at SICK. Today we would like to have a closer look about the commissioning of our gas flow meter FLOWSIC550. Before we get started, all activities described in the chapter mounting and electrical installation of the operating instructions must be completed. If stipulated by national regulations, all actions interfere with metrological relevant parameters must be done under official supervision. You can perform the commissioning of the FLOWSIC 550 by using our user software FLOWgate and your PC. Or you can use our FLOWgate mobile app and a Bluetooth connection to the device. In this video, we will carry out the commissioning via our user software FLOWgate on a PC. To start the commissioning, we need to connect to the device via our user software FLOWgate. Connect the service adapter to the service interface and the USB plug to your PC. You need to press a push button located on the side of the FLOWSIC 550 to activate the service interface. Please note that the display and the service interface has got a timeout of approximately 5 minutes if there will be no button pushed or data transmission takes place. Now you are able to establish a connection via FLOWgate. Add the FLOWSIC 550 to the device manager of FLOWgate operating software and create a connection to the device. We will log in with user level admin. Please check your delivery documents for the standard password for authorized user and admin. After successful login, the overview page is displayed. Start a field commissioning wizard and follow the step-by-step instructions. To start the commissioning wizard, the configuration mode must be activated to change parameters. Therefore, click on the wrench icon in the toolbar to activate the configuration mode. The first step of the commissioning wizard is device identification. Check the device serial number and type code. Compare the entries against the type plate and enter a device name. Optionally, the GPS coordinates of the gas meter can also be entered. This allows the location of the gas meter to be displayed on Google Maps. In the next step, system user, you are able to set date and time and to execute a user management. Enter the date and time or synchronize it with the PC. The units of your FLOWSIC 550 are set at the factory as ordered. Check the settings and adapt when necessary. For user management, SICK recommends changing the initial password provided for the authorized user for security reasons. Please refer to the delivery documentation for the device-specific admin password. Further users can be activated if desired. Therefore, activate the associated checkbox of the desired user and specify a password. The password must consist of 4 digits. Up to 3 users and 3 authorized users can be activated. For the power management, select the power management configuration. Next step is the page Warnings. Here you have the option to set warning limits. The standard limits for neutral gas applications are set at the factory. Configure the warning limits as desired for your application. The warnings signaled by the device can be individually activated or deactivated. Activate single warnings as desired. Now you have the option to configure archives and logbooks. For the logbooks, select the counter which is used for logbook entries. Configure the event logbook mode. You can select stopping mode, means a warning is output when the logbook is full, and rolling mode means the oldest entries will be overwritten by new ones. Activate or deactivate the metrology logbook. For the data archive settings, the interval of diagnostic archive is set at the factory, by default 60 minutes. In the next step, we will talk about I/O configuration. Here the parameters can be set for the interfaces available in accordance with the ordered configuration. Therefore, set the protocol type, Modbus configuration, baud rate, Modbus address, the protocol bits and the time delay. If your FLOWSIC 550 has got the option volume conversion, you are able to configure the electronic volume converter. Determine the reference values. Enter the specifications for gas characteristics. Select the algorithm and parameters for calculating the compressibility factor and enter fixed values. After completing the main part of the commissioning wizard, we have reached the final step. If desired, reset the counters and clear the logbooks and archives. SIG recommends creating a parameter report and archiving the report with the delivery documentation. To complete the commissioning of the FLOWSIC 550, we need to check the device status. Therefore, have a look to the displayed device status and check the diagnostic values in FLOWgate. Click on the symbol in the status bar when warnings or errors exist. The current status overview opens and shows details and information on how to proceed further. With that, we have reached the end of our video and I would like to thank you for your attention. If you have any open questions, please feel free to get in touch with your local SIG subsidiary. Please refer also to our user manuals and operating instructions. Thank you for choosing SIG and stay healthy. See you next time.